scratch out the pleasant simple tune without breaking his neck? It isn't easy. Now you may ask, why do we stay up there if it's so dangerous? We stay because Anatevka is our home. How do we keep our balance? That I can tell you in one word.
And then
It's under the constable. It's under the priest. And it's under. And many others. And so far we don't bother them, and they don't bother us. And among ourselves, we get along very well. There was this one time when he sold him a horse, but
he delivered a mule.
Oh, but that's all settled now. Now we live in peace and harmony.
It was the horse.
It was the mule.
It was the horse.
I should know the difference between a horse and a mule.
Oh, the news.
It's about Laser Wolf, the butcher. A good man, a fine man. You might not have to remind you that he's well off. Well, he's lonely, the poor man. You understand? To make it short, out of the whole town, he's cast his eyes on Cycle.
My Cycle?
No, it's our Cycle. Of course your Cycle.
Such a match for my Cycle. But Teddy wants a learned man. He doesn't like Laser.
Listen to me, Golda. Send Ted after him. Don't tell him what it's about. Let Laser discuss it himself. He's a good man, a wealthy man, too. So you'll tell me how it went, and you don't have to thank me, because aside from my fee, which anyway, Laser will pay, it gives me satisfaction to make you all happy. What better satisfaction is this? Goodbye, Golda. You're welcome.
What did she want, Mama?
When I want you to know, I'll tell you. Here, finish washing the floor. I wonder if Yetta found a husband for you.
I'm not anxious for Yetta to find me a husband.
Not unless it's my old tailor.
I didn't ask you!
Sidle, you're the oldest. They have to make a match for you before they can make one for me.
And then after her, one for me.
So if Yetta brings you a man, then...
Yetta. Yetta.
Well, somebody has to arrange the matches. Young people cannot decide these things for themselves. She might be someone wonderful, someone interesting,
and well off,
and important. Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match.
Beat you every night, but only when he's sober. So you're all right.
old horse lose his shoe right before the Sabbath? It wasn't nice. It's enough to pick on me, your friend Neb, you're blessing with 5 daughters, a life of poverty. What have you got against my old horse? Sometimes I think when things get quiet up there, you sit and think to yourself, oh, let's see what kind of mischief I can play on my friend Neb.
Oh, you're finally here, my breadwinner.
Talk to you later.
Where's your horse?
He was invited to the blacksmith's for the Sabbath.
Hurry up, the sun won't wait for you. I have something to say to you.
As the good book says, heal us, O Lord, and we shall be healed. Which in other words means, send us a cure, we got the sickness already. I'm not really complaining. I mean, after all your hard work, I'm starving to death. I understand you made many, many poor people. And I realize it's no shame to be poor. But it's no great honor either. So what trouble would it be if I had just a small fortune? If I were a rich man, yet it be the da-da-do-do-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da- wealthy man wouldn't have to work hard. You can need a dirty, you can need a dirty, you need a dog. If I were a very rich, deedle-titled man, I'd have a big tall house with rooms by the dozen right in the middle of the town. A fine tin roof with real wooden floors below. There would be one long staircase just going up, and one even longer going down, and one more leading nowhere just for show. I'd fill my yard with chicks and turkeys and geese and ducks for the town to see and hear, squawking just so noisily as they can. And each loud squawk would sound like a trumpet on the ears, as if to say, here comes a wealthy man. If I were a rich man, yes, a dee da 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 da. All day long I'd spinny, spinny bum. If I were a wealthy man, wouldn't have to work hard. Yes, a dee da 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 da. If I were a spinny, spinny rich, deedle-titled man, I'd see my wife, my Golda, looking like a rich man's wife with a proper double chin, supervising meals to her heart's delight. I'd see her putting on airs and strutting like a peacock. Oh, what a happy mood she's in, screaming at the servants day and night. The most important men in town will come to fawn on me. They will ask me to advise them like King Solomon the Wise. Oh, pardon me, Reptavia, if you please, Reptavia. Causing problems that would cross a rabbi's eyes. Boy, 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 boy. And it won't make one bit of difference if I answer right or wrong. Because when you're rich, they think you really know. If I I'd have the time that I lack to sit in a synagogue and pray, and maybe have a seat by the eastern wall. And I'd discuss the holy books with the learned men 7 hours every day. This would be the sweetest thing of all. Oh, man. If I were a wealthy man, hey! Wouldn't have to work harder. He has a diesel rider, and he's a dynasty of dumb. Lord, who made the life and the land? You decreed I should be what I am! Would it spoil some vast eternal plan? If I were a wealthy man.
Tevye, you forgot the rabbi's order.
Yes, Remendel.
Tevye, you forgot my order for the Sabbath.
Oh, this is bigger news than the plague in Odessa.
Talking about news, terrible news from the outside world. Terrible.
What is it?
What does it say?
In a city called Brianto, all the Jews were evicted, forced to leave their homes.
For what reason?
It doesn't say. Maybe the Tsar wanted their lands, maybe a plague.
May the Tsar have his own personal plague.
Amen.
Why don't you ever bring us any good news?
I only read it and was needed from the authorities.
May the authorities start itching in places they cannot reach.
Amen.
Why do you curse them? What good does your cursing do? You stand around and curse and do absolutely nothing.
We all curse you in the grave.
Excuse me, you're not from this village.
No.
And where is it you're from?
Kiev. I was a student at the university there.
Ah, the university. Is that where you learn to criticize your elders?
That's where I learn there's more to life than talk. You should know what's happening in the outside world.
Why should I bust my head over the outside world? Let them bust their own heads.
And he's right. As the good book says, if you spit in the air, it lands in your face.
That's nonsense. You cannot close your eyes to what's happening.
He's right.
He's right, and he's right. How can they both be right?
You know, you are also right.
He's right. He's still a little bit behind the ears. Good Sabbath, Tevye.
Good Sabbath.
Good Sabbath, Tevye.
Tevye at the rabbi's order? My cheese?
So, you're from Kiev, Rev.
Gurchin.
Gurchin. So, you're a newcomer here. As Abraham said, I am a stranger in a strange land.
Moses said that.
Forgive me. As King David put it, I am slow of speech and slow of tongue.
That was also Moses.
For a man with a slow tongue, he talked a lot.
And the cheese.
Here. Have a piece.
Oh, I have no money and I have no bank.
Here. It's a blessing for me to give.
Very well, for your sake.
Thank you. You know, it's no crime to be poor.
In this world, it's the richer of the criminals. One day their wealth will be ours.
That would be nice. If they would agree, I would agree.
And who will make this miracle come to pass?
People, ordinary people.
Like you.
Like me?
Nonsense.
Until your golden day comes, Rev. Gurchik, how will you live?
And by giving lessons to children. Do you have any?
I have 5 daughters.
5?
Daughters.
Oh, ghosts of them 2 girls are people.
A radical!
I would be willing to teach them. Open their minds to the great thoughts.
What great thoughts?
The Bible has many lessons for our times.
I am a very poor man. Food for lessons? Good. Why don't you stay the Sabbath with us? Well, we don't eat like kings, but we don't starve either. As the good book says, if a man eats a chicken, one of them is sick.
Where does the good book say that?
It doesn't exactly say that, but someplace it has something about a chicken. Good Sabbath.
Good Sabbath.
Good Sabbath. Perjik, this is my oldest daughter.
Good Sabbath.
Good Sabbath.
You have a very pleasant daughter.
I have 5 very pleasant daughters. This is mine. 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 Oh! That is not mine. Perjik, this is Muggle Cam's oil, and he is
a so you did me a favor and came in.
This is also mine. Golda. This is Perchik. He is from Kiev. He's staying the Sabbath with us. He is also a teacher. Would you like to take lessons with him?
I am a really good teacher. A very good teacher.
I heard once the rabbi who must praise himself as a congregation of one.
Your daughter has a quickening way, Tom.
The wit she gets from me, as the good book says.
The good book can wait. Get washed.
The tongue she gets from her mother.
Are you also leaving with us? Of course, another blessing. So I go do more. Sprinza, be out there, get washed. Mother can help me. All right, get the table. Ava, you go too. You can wash outside for the wedding. Devia, I have to tell you something.
Why should today be different?
Devia, I must tell you.
Shh! I'm praying.
Laser Wolf wants to see you.
The books are about what?
I don't know, only he says it's important.
What can be important? I have nothing for him to slaughter.
After the Sabbath, you will see him and you will talk.
Talk to him about what? If he wants to buy my new milk cow, we can forget it.
Devia, don't be an ox. A man sends an important message. The least you can do is talk to him.
I'll talk to him about what? He wants to buy my new milk cow.
Stop, Devia!
All right, after the Sabbath, I'll talk to him.
Mogenta was here.
I saw her.
If they agree on someone, then there will be a match, but it will be too late for us.
Don't worry, Seidel. I have found someone who will sell me his used sewing machine. So, in a few weeks, I'll have saved up enough money to buy it, and then your father will be impressed with me.
But, Muddle, a few weeks may be too late.
What else can we do?
You can ask my father for my hand tonight. Now!
Now? Why should I ask him now? Why should he accept me now? I'm only a poor tailor.
I'm only the daughter of a poor milkman. Just talk to him.
Seidel, if your father says no, then that's it. It's final. He'll yell at me. Just a poor tailor.
Muddle, even a poor tailor is entitled to some happiness.
That's true.
Will you talk to him? Will you talk to him?
All right, I'll talk to him.
Where is everybody? Late? Late. Come, children, we're lighting the candles. Yes, Muddle.
Excuse me?
Yes, Muddle, what is it?
Yes, Muddle. Yes, Muddle, what is it? Good Sabbath,
good Sabbath. Come, children, come.
Thank you.
I'll be happy to aid in the festivities, lead the dancing and such. For a small fee, of course.
Naturally, a wedding is no wedding without you. And your fee.
Good evening, innkeeper.
Good evening.
We'd like you to get up, sit down.
Vodka, schnapps?
Vodka.
Good evening.
Good evening, Devin.
Tavia, what are you doing here so early?
He wants to buy my new milk cow.
Oh.
Good evening, Reblazer.
Ah, Tavia, sit down, have a drink.
I won't insult you by saying no.
So, how goes it with you, Tavia?
How should it go,
right?
And you?
Same.
Sorry to hear that.
How's your brother-in-law in America?
I believe he's doing well.
Oh, he wrote to you?
Not lately.
Then how do you know?
He was doing badly, he arrived.
Well, Tavia, I suppose you know why I wanted to see you this evening.
Yes, and there's no use talking about it.
Well, why not?
Why, yes, why should I get rid of her?
Well, you'll have a few more without her.
Oh, I see how it is. Today you want one, tomorrow you may want two.
Two? What would I do with two?
Same you do with one?
Tavia, this is very important to me.
Why is it so important to you?
Frankly, because I'm lost.
Lonesome? What are you talking about?
You don't know?
We're talking about the new milk cow, the one you want to buy from me.
A milk cow, so it won't be lonesome.
What's so funny?
I'm talking about your daughter. Your daughter, Tsidle.
My daughter, Tsidle?
Of course your daughter, Tsidle. I see her in my butcher shop every Thursday. She's made a good impression on me, Captain. And I like her. And as for me, as you know, I'm pretty well off. I have a house, a good store, a servant. Listen, Heaven, we don't have to impress each other. Let's just shake hands, call it a match. You won't need a dowry for her. You might even find something in your own.
Shame on you! My purse, my title is not the kind I would sell for money.
All right, just as you say, we won't talk about the money. Thing is, let's get it done. I will be good to her, Tavia. I like her. What do you think?
What do I think? What do I think? I never liked him. Why should I? You can have a fine conversation with him if we're talking about livers or kidneys. On the other hand, not everybody has to be a scholar. If with the butcher around, my daughter will surely never stop. On the other hand, she's much younger than him. That's his problem, but he's much older than her. That's my problem. I always thought of him as a butcher, but I misjudged him. He's a good man. He likes her. He will try to make her happy. What do I think? It's a match!
Oh, you agree?
I agree.
Tavia, this is wonderful. Let's drink up.
To you.
No, my friend, to you.
To the both of us.
Our agreement.
To our agreement. To our prosperity. To our good health and happiness. And most important, to life. To life. L'chaim. 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 To life. Kiss to the father I try to be.
Kiss to my bride to be.
Drink. Let's
Now, children, I will tell you a story from the Bible of Laban and Jacob, and then we will discuss it afterwards, all right? Very good. Now, Laban had two daughters, Leah and the beautiful Rachel. And Jacob loved the youngest Rachel, so he asked Laban for her hand. Laban agreed only if Jacob would work for him for 7 years.
Was Laban a mean man?
He was an employer! So after the 7 years were up, do you know what happened? Laban fooled him and gave him the ugly daughter Leah. So to marry Rachel, Jacob would have to work another 7 years. You see, the Bible clearly teaches us you must never trust an employer. Do you understand?
Yes, Richard. Yes, Richard.
Very good. Now, if we look
at... Papa's still lit up yet?
No, Mama. But we have to do his work today. He staggered home last night and fell into bed like a dead man. I could barely get a word out of him. Put those books away and go clean the barn. Call me when Papa wakes up. That was a very interesting lesson today, Pritchard.
Do you think so?
Although I don't think the rabbi would agree with your interpretation.
And neither, I suppose, would the rabbi's son.
My little sisters have big tongues.
And what do you know about him, except that he's the rabbi's son? Would you be interested in him if he were the tinsmith's son or the shoemaker's son?
At least I know this. He doesn't have any strange ideas about turning this world upside down.
Surely any new idea would be strange to you. Remember, the Lord said, let there be light.
Yes, but he wasn't talking to you personally.
You have spirit, maybe even intelligence, perhaps.
Thank you.
But what good is your brain without curiosity? It's just a rusty tool. Good day, Hado.
We have an old custom here. A boy acts respectfully to you. But of course that is too traditional for an advanced thinker like you.
Oh, our traditions. Everything is perfect. Nothing must change.
We like our ways.
Our ways are changing all over but here. Here men and women must keep apart. Men study, women in the kitchen. Must not even touch, cannot even look at each other.
I will catch you.
You are very brave. Do you know that in the city, boys and girls can be affectionate without permission of a matchmaker? They even dance together. New dances like this. You just keep following me. Dirty. Do you like it? I learned it in Kiev.
It's, very nice.
Have a little joy in our old age after all our hard work.
Your tenure.
Later, Muddle, later.
I would like to speak to you.
Later, Muddle, I have problems.
That's what I would like to speak to you about. I think I can help.
Certainly, like a bandage can help a corpse. Goodbye, Muddle.
At least listen to him, Papa.
You have a tongue, talk.
I hear you are arranging a match for Seidel.
Oh, he also has ears.
I have a match for Seidel.
What kind of match?
A perfect fit.
A perfect fit.
Like a glove.
Like a glove.
This match was made exactly to measure.
Made to measure, perfect fit, like a glove. Stop talking like a tailor and tell me who is it.
Please don't shout at me.
All right.
Wonders, miracle of miracles.
God took a Daniel once again, stood by his side, and miracle of miracles, walked him through the lion's den. Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, I was afraid that God would frown, but like he did so long ago in Jericho, God just made all fall down. When Moses saw in Pharaoh's heart, that was a miracle. When God made the waters of the Red Sea part, that was a miracle too. But of all God's miracles, large and small, the most miraculous one of all is that out of a worthless lump of clay, God has made a man. When God gave us manna in the wilderness, that was a miracle too. But of all God's miracles, large and small, the most miraculous one of all is the one we thought would never be. God has
Muzzle top, muzzle top.
model. The tailor. That's terrible. Model got model.
Imagine, Seidelberry model.
I can't believe it.
What's wrong with my son? Model.
Oh, excuse the shade of model
talk.
Yosel, do you have a wedding hat for me?
They still won't afford a hat. It's not cheap.
Why, it was bride. I can get his hat.
And come, Bottle, come.
Pava, my boss can shut up with me for a few minutes. Thank you, Pava.
Come, Pava. I'll show you.
We just heard about it, sister.
Thank you.
Mazel tov, Pava.
Mazel tov, Pava.
Mazel tov, Pava. Mazel tov, Pava.
Please, may I pass?
Why, we're congratulating you.
Mazel tov, Pava.
All right, stop it.
Now, what's wrong with you?
Just stop it.
Now, listen here, Fiat.
Goodbye, Sasha. I said goodbye. I'm sorry about that. They mean no harm.
Don't they? Is there something you want?
Yes, I'd like to talk to you.
I'd rather not.
I've often noticed you at the booksellers. Not many girls in this village like to read. Would you like to borrow this book? It's very good.
No, thank you.
Why? Because I'm not Jewish? Do you feel about us the way they feel about you? I didn't think you would.
What do you know about me?
Let me tell you a little bit about myself. I'm a pleasant fellow, charming, ambitious, quite bright, and very modest.
I don't think we should be talking this way.
I often do things that I shouldn't. Here, take the book. It's by Heinrich Heine. It happens to be Jewish, I believe.
That doesn't matter.
Quite right. Good. After you return it, I'll ask you how you like it, and then we'll talk about it for a while. Then we'll talk about life, the way we feel about things, and it could all turn out quite pleasant.
Oh, hello, here's something I can do for you.
No, thank you.
You forgot your book.
No, it's mine.
Thank you, Hava.
Oh, good day, Hava. Yep.
Good day.
Sunrise, sunset, sunrise, sunset.
joy of the newlyweds, Mottl and Zeidel. May they live together to a ripe old age.
Mazel
tov! Oh, and here comes our beloved rabbi. May he be with us for many, many years.
Amen.
Amen.
I want to announce that the bride's parents are giving the newlyweds the following. A new feather bed and these pillows.
Goose pillows.
Goose pillows and these candlesticks. Now, let us not in our happiness soon forget those who are no longer with us. Our dear departed, who lived in pain and poverty and hardship, and died in pain and poverty and hardship. But enough tears. Let us be merry and content, like our good friend Laser Boy, who has everything in the world, except the bride. But Laser has no ill feelings. In fact, he has a gift for the newlyweds that he wants to announce himself. Come, Laser Boy.
As he said, I have no ill feelings. What's done is done. I'm giving the newlyweds 5 chickens. One for each of the first 5/7 of their wedded life.
Oh, Laser, you're a good man. On behalf of my daughter and her husband,
I accept your gift.
There's a saying that goes...
Tammy, I don't have to listen to your sayings. I'm not marrying your daughter.
You just listen, I was about to say.
Why should I listen to you? A man who breaks an agreement.
Hey, sir, not in the middle of a wedding.
I have a right to talk.
Oh, what right? This isn't your wedding.
It should have been!
Rebelings are doing shame on Teddy at his daughter's wedding.
He shamed me in front of the entire village!
Oh, shut up, the rabbi! Rabbi, say something.
I say, let's sit down.
You'll hear the wise words of the rabbi.
Now, I would like to sing a song.
Oh, you can keep your disease checked out. Chickens, out of this. We made an agreement.
The terms weren't settled.
We drink on it.
So, drink on
the terms weren't settled.
What's done is done.
Once a butcher, always a butcher.
I had a sign. My old friend on the side who came from the grave to tell us about the tale.
What sign? What grandmother?
My grandfather came to me in a dream and said that her grandmother's a big
liar.
We drank the
Quiet! What is all this screaming? A sigh, they drank on it, an agreement. It's all nonsense.
Quiet!
Simon wanted to marry Mottl and not Laser.
A young girl decide for herself?
Yes, why not? They love each other.
No! Terrible! He's a radical!
What happens to the matchmaker?
I say!
But, let's sit down.
Musicians, play a dance, a dance.
No sin to dance at a wedding.
But with a girl? This is what comes from bringing a wild man to your house.
He's not a wild man. His ideas are a little different than ours.
But it's a sin. It is no sin to dance at a wedding. Ask the rabbi, ask him.
Well, rabbi.
Dancing? Well, it's not exactly forbidden.
Well, dancing is not forbidden.
And it's no sin. Now who will dance with me? Yes! I'm gonna watch this one. keep you all for me.
Everyone standing around for. Clean up. Clean up. Thank you.
That was quite a dowry you gave my daughter Seidel at her wedding. Was that necessary? Anyways, Muddle and Seidel have been married 3 months now. They work very hard, but they're poor as synagogue mice. But they're so in love, they don't even know how miserable they are. Muddle talks about buying a new sewing machine. I know you're busy, God. Wars and floods and plagues and revolutions, you know, all the little things that bring people to you. You take some time off from your catastrophes and get informed. Or trouble with the thing. Oh, and while you're in the neighborhood, my horse is left leg. Am I bothering you? I'm sorry. As the good book says, why should I tell you what the good book says?
Upset, Otto.
Why should I be upset? If you must leave, you must.
I do have to. They expect me in Kiev tomorrow morning.
So you told me. Then goodbye.
Otto, great changes are about to take place all over the land. Tremendous change, but this cannot happen by itself.
So naturally, you feel...
Not only me. Many people, Gentiles, Jews, many people hate what is happening. Don't you understand?
Yes, of course. If you want to leave, then goodbye.
Otto, your fathers, the others here, they think that what happened at Zyla's wedding was a single outburst and we'll all be peaceful again. It won't. Horrible things are happening. Pogroms, violence, whole villages are being emptied of their people. And it will reach here. Do you understand?
Yes, I suppose I do.
I have work to do. The greatest work a man can do.
Then goodbye, Richard.
Before I go, I wish to discuss a certain question with you.
Yes?
It's a political question.
What is it?
The question of marriage.
This is a political question?
In a theoretical sense, yes. The relationship between a man and woman is based off of mutual beliefs, a common philosophy and attitude towards society.
And affection.
Yes. It reflects a unity and solidarity.
And affection.
Yes. And I am personally in favor of it. You understand?
Yes. I think you're asking me to marry you.
In a theoretical sense, yes.
Oh, I was hoping you were.
Then I take it you approve and we can consider ourselves engaged. I am very happy, Mother. Very happy.
So am I, Christian. What's the matter?
I used to tell myself that I had everything, but that was only half true. I had an aim in life, and that was everything, but now I even have you. I have something that I could die for, someone that I could live for too. Yes, and now I have everything, not only everything, I have a little bit more. Besides having everything, I know what everything's for. I used to wonder, could there be a wife to share such a difficult, wandering kind of life?
I was on the other side, waiting right here.
Who knows tomorrow where our home will be?
I'll be with you and that's long enough for me.
Everything is bright and left,
simple.
Life,
yes, but it would be less hard if we lived together.
Yes.
Good evening.
Good evening, Reptalia. I have some bad news. I must leave this place.
Leave? When?
As soon as I can.
Sorry. We'll all miss you, Kirk.
But I also have good news. You can congratulate me.
Oh, congratulations. What for?
We are engaged.
Engaged?
Yes, Papa. We're engaged.
Oh, no, you're not. I know. You like him and he likes you, but you're going away and you're staying here. So have a nice trip, Percy. I hope you'll be very happy. And my answer is no.
Please, Papa, you don't understand.
Oh, I understand. I gave Seidel and Mabel permission to become engaged, so you feel like you also have a right. Sorry, Percy, I like you, but you're going away, so go in good health, and my answer is still no.
Papa, you don't understand.
No, I'm not listening. Sorry, Hubble, but we'll find you someone else. Here, in Anantevia.
Reptevia.
What?
We are not asking for your permission. Only a blessing. We are getting married.
You're not asking for my permission.
But we would like your blessing, Papa.
I can't believe my own ears. My blessing for what? For going over my head. Impossible. At least with Simon and Mama. They asked me, they begged me. But now if I like it or not, she'll marry him. So what do you want from me? Go on, beware. And tear out my beard and the cover. One little time I've pulled up the thread, and where has it led? Where has it led? Where has it led? To this? A man who tells me he's getting married. He doesn't ask me, he tells me. But first, he abandons her?
He's not abandoning me, Papa.
I will send for her as soon as I can, and we will get married. I love her.
He loves her? Love. The new style. On the other hand, our old ways were once new, weren't they? On the other hand, they decided without parents, without the matchmaker. On the other hand, did Adam and Eve have a matchmaker? Yes. Yes, they did. And it seems these two have the same matchmaker. They're going over my head. Unheard of. Absurd. Would this day one be less impossible? I'll lock her up in her room. I couldn't. I should. But look in my daughter's face. She loves him. Run it! You have my blessing and my permission.
Oh, Papa, you don't know how happy this makes me.
What else can I do?
Thank you, Papa.
Thank you, Papa. What am I going to tell your mother? Another dream?
Perhaps you tell her something. I'm going to visit a rich uncle. Something like that.
Perfect. I can handle my own wife.
Oh, God.
Oh, Golda! Hello, Golda. I've just been talking to Percy and Hubble.
Well?
They seem to be very fond of each other.
Well?
I have decided to give them permission to become engaged. I have to go inside and...
What? Just like that? Without even asking me?
Who asks you? I'm the father.
What is he? A pauper? He has nothing. Absolutely nothing.
I wouldn't say that. I hear he has... a rich uncle. A very rich uncle. He's a good man, Golda. I like him. He's a little crazy, but I like him. And what's more important, Hado likes him. Hado loves him. So what else can we do? A new world, Golda. A new world. Love. Golda. You
Why, what?
Do you love me?
Do I love you? With our daughters getting married and this trouble in the town, you're upset, you're worn out. Go inside, go lie down. Maybe it's indigestion.
Golda, I'm asking you a question. Do you love me?
Oh, you're a fool.
Oh, I know. But do you love me?
Do I love you? For 25 years I've washed your clothes, cooked your meals, cleaned your house, given you children, milked the cow. After 25 years, why talk about love right now?
Golda, the first time I met you was on our wedding day. I was scared.
I was shy.
I was nervous.
So was I.
But my father and my mother said we'd learn to love each other. So now I'm asking Golda, do you love me?
I'm your wife!
I know! But do you love me?
Do I love him? For 25 years I've lived with him, fought with him, starved with him. 25 years my bed is his. If that's not
change a thing.
But even so, after 25 years, it's nice to
thank you.
You don't have to wait for the train, Papa. You'll be late for your customers.
Just a few more minutes. So, is he in big trouble, this hero of yours? Arrested? And convicted?
Yes, Papa, but he did nothing wrong. He cares nothing for himself. Everything he does is for humanity.
If he did nothing wrong, he wouldn't be in any trouble.
Papa, how can you say that? What wrongs did Joseph do, or Abraham, or Moses? And they had troubles.
But why won't you tell me where he is, this Joseph of yours?
It is far, Papa. Terribly far. He is in a settlement in Siberia.
Siberia? And he expects you to leave your mother and father and join him in that frozen wasteland and marry him then?
Papa, he did not ask me to go. I want to go. I don't want him to be alone. I want to help him in his work. It's the greatest work a man can do, Papa. But Papa, how can I hope to make you understand why I do?
Thank you.
must congratulate.
Grandpa, did you hear the news? A new arrival at Bubble and Cycles.
Really?
He told me they were married.
happened. You have work to do, I have work to do.
But
Grandma, it's done to us! It was forgotten. Now go home, Colton. How can I accept them? Can I deny everything I believe in? On the other hand, can I deny my own child? On the other hand, how can I turn my back on my faith, my people, if I try to bend that far, I will break? On the other hand, there is no other hand. No! Chava, no! No!
Chava!
Thank you.
for which one?
What's the difference? Take your pick.
Golda, is your Octavia here?
Yes, but he's in the house. Why?
Spencer, call your father.
Go home, boys. Tell your parents I'll talk to them.
What's going on? Why are you all gathered around with a bunch of goats?
Octavia, have you seen the constable today?
No, what? There are some rumors in town. We thought because you knew him so well. Maybe he told you what's true and what's not.
What rumors?
Someone who was alone told me that there was an edict issued.
Good evening.
Good evening, Your Honor. What's the good news in the world?
I see your company.
They are my friends.
It's just as well. What I have to say is for their ears also. Oh, Octavia. How much time do you need to sell your house and all your household goods?
Why would I sell my house? Is it in anybody's way?
I'm here to tell you that you're going to have to leave Enetevka.
How do I come to deserve such an honor?
Well, it's not just you, it's all of you. At first, I thought you might be spared because you're not our father.
My daughter is dead.
I understand. But at any rate, it affects all of you. You have to leave.
But this corner of the world has always been ours. But why should we leave?
There's trouble in the world, Tevye. Troublemakers!
Oh my God!
It's not just you, it's all of you. The people of Zelodin, Rebelevka, all the districts must be empty. I have no order here. It says you must sell your homes and be out of here in 3 days.
3 days?
You, who have known us all your life, you would carry out this order.
I have nothing to do with it. You understand?
We understand.
And what if we refuse to go?
You'll be forced out.
We will defend ourselves!
Terrible.
Refuse to leave
our land! Fight!
Against our army? I wouldn't advise it.
I have some advice for you. Get off my land! This is still my home and my land, no? Now get off my land!
You have 3 days.
The peace of Tiger! And then get thee out!
We should get together with the people of Zelodin. Maybe they have a plan.
We should defend ourselves! An eye for an eye! A tooth! For a tooth.
Very good. That way the whole town will be blind and toothless.
Papa, we've been waiting for the Messiah to come all our lives. Wouldn't it be great if he came now?
We'll have to wait for him someplace else. In the meantime, let's not pack him.
He's right. I'll see you before I go.
3 days?
I have over 100 bottles of vodka. What will I do with them?
Where will I move a wife, her parents, and 3 children?
Well, Anatevka hasn't exactly been the Garden of Eden.
That's true.
Besides, what have we got here? A little bit of this, a little bit of that.
A pot.
A pad.
A broom.
A hat.
Somebody should have set a match to this place years ago. A bench.
A tree.
So it's a stove.
Or a house.
People who pass your head at Tempur don't even know that they've been here.
A stick of wood.
A piece of coal.
What do we need? Nothing much.
Where else could Saladin
fathers have been forsaken many, many places at a moment's notice.
Maybe that's why we always wear our hats.
Maybe it would be better if I went inside and told Mama that... Also leaving this place. Some are driven away by edicts, others by silence.
Thank you.